is Ruff.
Pretty great, huh? It's a prototype for the new Action to the Maction Action Ruff action figure, based on yours truly. Oh, not impressed? Well, you will be. When I press this button on his back, Action to the Maction will flip onto this plank, perform some hip dance moves, and then execute black belt level karate chops. Go, Action Ruff, go!
I am very cool. My name is Ruff.
It's just the prototype. I mean, I've got a professional puppeteer book for today's show. Now he'll make Action Ruff, you know, actually work. Oh, the bulb needs tightening. But I need to get the ladder out before I... Wow. Okay, not bad. But it can't hold a candle to the real Action of the Maction, Ruff Ruffman. You just watch me do some karate chop dance moves on that fence in the yard. Check it out. Okay, not good. Call my vet now. Life was missing its mystique. My squeaky toys had lost their squeak. And then, out of the blue, I saw the phone, and bam! My destiny was calling me. Pitched my vision for a show. They loved it. Thought I was a pro. They got my contract back to fine. To their alarm, a dog hit sign. Oh, I like that name. To renovate, found six contestants, all were great, and now I'm on the road to fame. I've got a game show and its name is, it's very catchy, it rolls off the tongue. Wait, stop.
Somebody want to tell me why we got cats singing?
And here come the contestants now. She can fold her tongue two ways, Nina. He enjoys classical music, Rosario. He loves the smell of strawberries, Willie. She loves water parks, except when water goes up her nose, it's Betty. The beach makes her happy, surf's up, Bridget. He knows how to use a Chinese yo-yo, yo, Mike. Let's get an update on the scores. In sixth place with 155 points is Rosario. Willie has nosedived to the 5 spot with 205 points. Nina holds on to the 4 spot with 210 points. Bridget has jumped up to 3rd place with 215 points. Maddie in 2nd place with 220 points. And our new leader with 225 points, Mike. Hello and welcome to Fetch, the reality game show, where the action is definitely to the maction. Seemed like I was dancing on top of a fence in sunglasses to show off my balance to a cat, but actually, I
that's exactly what I was doing.
You're showing off to a cat.
That's not even the worst part. Charlene, the poodle next door, saw the whole thing.
Charlene.
This is so embarrassing. I went to the vet and they put this cone on me because I'm not supposed to lick the wound. Believe me, I have no desire to lick any wound whatsoever. It's probably just a sprain. The vet says I might need an x-ray, but that would mean going to the animal hospital, and that's not gonna happen.
Why not?
Because hospitals, are kind of scary.
They're not scary, Ruff.
I don't do hospitals. They freak me out a little bit. But anyway, it brings us to challenge number one. Now, this is an important challenge because it has to do with my psyche. Convince your host that he's being ridiculous about hospitals. You're going to meet my good buddy, William. He's going to give you a tour of the hospital. But all your instructions are in the mailbox. So, Rosario, Bridget, go fetch!
Have fun, you guys.
Have fun.
Bye.
Yeah, have lots of fun at the hospital. Pepperdoodle Blossom over here thinks she knows a thing or two about balancing, which brings us to challenge number two.
Nice.
This is Dr. Roush. He's an otologist. He definitely knows about balancing. And Willie, Mike, you definitely know a thing or two about fetching for points. Everything you need to know is in the mailbox. Go fetch! Oh, it hurts to say fetch.
Bye, guys.
Now, as determined by the Fetch 3000, Maddie and Nina have stayed behind in the studio this week.
Yeah.
They'll be eligible to win points during the halftime quiz show. And as always, we bring to you, fresh, the Fetch Fair is guaranteed. All the contestants will have competed for the same number of points by the grand finale. For the 4 kids out on the challenges, up to 100 points are at stake in the triumph tally. So even though it gives me the heebie-jeebies, let's go to the hospital with Rosario and Bridget. I don't like hospitals.
Come back.
So we're looking for William.
Are you William?
Yes.
Hi, William. I'm Rosaria.
I'm Bridget.
Let's begin.
Where are we going to start?
The gift shop.
The gift shop?
Yeah, a lot of gifts.
Oh, yeah. Are there any dogs?
Yeah. Look, Ruff, it's Charlene.
It looks just like her.
Oh, I don't want her to see me like this. Somebody go, my fur.
So why do you have these casts?
Because they had surgery. You're going to meet Maria. She's one of the nurses here.
Hi, William. Hi. I hear you guys are here because, Ruff, I heard you might have broke a bone.
I think so. It could be a femur.
When you fall, see the bone? It sometimes breaks, just like a pencil or a branch on a tree.
Where's the bone broke?
The bone broke right there. See, it's not a straight line.
Oh, not at all.
See,
I'm going to throw
it. Looks like after this one was fixed.
Yeah.
So the break is right there, and the pins hold the bone straight. Here's a picture of it when it was all fixed.
So that's just a normal leg?
Yep.
Well, it looks good as new. Oh, man. Willie and Mike are in another hospital.
Second floor.
Hi.
There's the doctor.
Hi. How you doing?
Good. I'm Dr. Rausch.
I'm Willie.
How do you do?
Michael.
We're here to learn some...
Then about otology.
Yeah.
About otology. You know what otology is?
No.
Odo is a Latin word. It means ear. So I'm an ear doctor. And that means I take care of patients who have trouble with hearing and with balance.
My hearing's good. Balance, I'm having the problem.
The balance system is all through your body. It gets information from your ears, your eyes, your muscles, and all of those sources of information come together in your brain, and then the balance system sends signals back out again so you can walk and move around without falling over. So what brings you guys here today?
Well, Ruff sent us to figure out how we can get better at balancing.
Well, why don't you come with me and maybe we can figure that out.
Okay.
Wow, that's a big ear.
Now I'm gonna show you a room
where we would stay overnight.
Yeah. Hi.
Who's this?
Addie.
Hey, it's Abby.
So how's the food in the hospital?
You just dial F-O-O-D and you can order whatever food you want.
So you could have ice cream for breakfast?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, really?
That's not bad.
I can get food this way? Oh, man. F-O-O-D.
Oh, what should I order? What should I order?
Someone's on the other line. Man. Yellow.
Hey, Ruff, it's John.
John, hi. John, I should know that.
John Kennedy, the puppeteer?
Oh, I forgot to cancel the puppeteer! Oh!
Yeah, well, where are the kids?
What kids? They're in the children's hospital, and they're on the ninth floor.
Okay.
Okay, a puppet hospital challenge. We'll roll with it. Yes, ow! And without all four legs, rolling's pretty much all we can do.
We have some ways to see what do you need your vision for, what do you need your muscles for, what do you need your ears for, and try to take the balance system apart into its different pieces, and you really need 2 out of 3 to balance.
Oh, so if you couldn't see, you can't balance?
It's harder. In fact, it's a great question. If you stand with your feet together, it's easy to stand. What if you stand like that, and then you cross your arms? Now close your eyes. When you close your eyes, you're taking away the vision.
It's harder.
Harder. You're just using your ear and wiggling around, trying to use your muscles to stay up. What about your buddy Ruff? What's your advice for him?
Take off the glasses.
Okay, goodbye, dark glasses. I get it. You need to see well in order to balance well.
So, William, where are we going to now?
The activity room. Last stop on our tour.
The activity room.
Well, thank you.
Yes. I gotta go.
Thanks, William.
Do better, Ruff.
Thanks, William. You too, buddy. I told the puppeteer to meet them here. Where is he?
Oh, this is cool.
Hi. Up there he is.
I'm Bernie the Pig. How you doing?
Good.
Hey, Ruff. How's it going?
Not too bad, Bernie. You know, I get my legs kind of... I'm talking to a puppet.
Now let me introduce you to my creator.
Hi, everybody.
Hey, hi, John.
I'm John Kennedy, and I'm a puppeteer.
Oh, cool.
And today, I'm going to teach you how to make your own puppets.
Oh, awesome.
How to perform them. Yeah. And then we're going to do a show for Ruff about his stay here at the hospital.
It's going to take a lot more than a puppet show to make me come to the hospital.
A Let me show you some of the puppets in my trunk that I brought all the way up to the 9th floor.
What? What are you looking at me for?
Here they are.
You made all of them?
I made all these puppets.
Those are awesome.
I even made Bernie.
Yeah, don't forget about me.
These are awesome.
Thanks. Yeah.
There are 5 balance organs in the ear.
Now they're going to test their inner ear.
The inner ear, where the balance organs are, is filled with fluid. And when you spin real fast, the fluid is moving. After you've twirled around and you get that inner ear fluid moving, it makes the brain think you're still moving. Just like stirring water in a glass. And if you stop stirring, the water keeps swirling for a little bit. And so your balance system takes ear information, takes eyes, and it kind of connects them. This is a fancy camera. Let me show you what this does. It's infrared. Now look at the screen. You see my eyes?
That's awesome.
What we're going to do is we're going to have one of you guys spin around.
Try to catch your tail, Mike.
We'll be able to see on the camera what your eyes are doing. There, open your eyes wide, wide, wide. And what are they doing?
They're moving. They're like crazy and they're cross-eyed.
Wait, they're still moving. But he's not moving.
The ears are telling the brain that you're turning. So the eyes are doing what they do when you turn.
So when you stop spinning around, your brain thinks you're still turning?
So you shouldn't spin next time, Rob.
Don't spin. Your eyes twitch.
You can't tell a dog not to spin. I mean, seriously, with this tail, it's too tempting. Hi, Ruffman here in agony. Back in Studio G with Maddie and Nina. Are you girls ready for the halftime quiz show?
Yeah!
Good, it's time to earn some points of your own. 50 points are available. You have 90 seconds to answer as many questions as you can. 10 questions available at 5 points apiece. Okay, are you ready?
Yeah.
Then let the quiz begin. What are the 4 letters kids dial in the hospital to be fed?
F-O-O-D.
My favorite word. Awesome. Dr. Rouse practices what field of medicine?
Your body.
Otology.
Correct.
It's a department. Otology.
On their hospital tour, where did Rosario and Bridget go first?
The gift shop.
Great. Name the 3 parts of a body's balance system.
Ears, eyes, and muscles.
Correct. What was I wearing on the fence that did not help my balance?
The sunglasses.
Excellent. Why did Mike and Willie feel like they were still spinning even after they stopped?
Because the fluid in their ears were still moving around.
The inner ear, where the balance organs are, is filled with fluid, and when you spin real fast, the fluid is moving.
Correct. You can't balance without vision, true or false?
False.
Correct. What is the name of the puppet that first greets Bridget and Rosario?
Ernie the Pig.
Who?
Yeah, Ernie. Ernie or Bernie?
Is it Ernie or Bernie?
Ernie.
You're wrong. What kind of camera does Dr. Rouse use to look at Mike and Willie's eyes?
Laser eye? Laser. Skip.
We're done. Woo. Guess how many points you got?
How many?
35. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
All right, let's go over the questions you didn't get right. What is the name of the puppet that first greets Bridget and Rosario?
Hey, I'm Bernie the Pig.
It's Bernie the Pig. Really, all Bernie is Ernie with a B. What kind of camera does Dr. Rouse use to look at Mike and Willie's eyes? Infrared.
Oh.
Still, 35 points is awesome. Oh, it hurts.
Ruff, you need to get to a doctor.
I know. That's what my fetchers are out there trying to convince me of. Get back to Willie and Mike, whose challenge hangs in the balance. See, I'm not too much in pain to throw a joke out there, right?
Your muscles are also sending information to help you stand up straight and move around without falling over.
And host a fantastic reality game show, yes, okay.
This is a testing machine that lets us take away some of that information a little bit at a time. Michael, this is a test where we're going to let you use your eyes and inner ear to balance, but we're not going to let you use your muscles.
How do you keep somebody from using their muscles?
Lean forward or back. The floor is going to move forward or back with you. So it's stealing information that usually comes from your ankle muscle.
Normally, when you're standing on the floor and you lean forward, the floor pushes back on your feet. But when Mike leans forward on this platform, the floor tilts forward too. So his muscles can't send his brain any information to help him balance. He's all over the place.
It was a little bit harder than I thought when you can't use your muscles, because your muscles play an important role in balance.
What are you going to tell Ruff?
We're going to tell Ruff to take off his glasses, take off the foam shoes, and the best thing is not to dance on a fence.
Very good advice, Willie. Thank you. Time out here. I got to give these guys a call. Hey, guys.
Oh, hey, Ruff.
Hey, Ruff.
Need you guys to head out to the park.
Oh, park? Where's the park?
It's outside.
We're outside.
It's the one outside the door.
Okay, we'll try and look for it, all right?
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ruff.
Thanks a lot.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
I'm trying to establish some scenes here. Ruff's accident. Do you remember what happened with that?
Yeah, he fell off a fence.
He was on a fence.
Trying to act like a cat.
So we'll start out with this whole little jealousy thing that he has. Because it's great to show puppets and their emotions, right?
Me? Jealous? Of a cat? Please.
Who'd you meet on the tour?
We met Maria.
She's a nurse. Would you like to play Ruff then?
Sure.
Yeah?
Be an honor.
My initial choice was Robert De Niro, but you know what? Right after that, Rosario would be an excellent Ruffman.
So you could play Maria the Bunny Nurse.
Okay.
Right? And you come in and you sort of console him. And we're going to perform this for the whole... This could be fun. We just got to make the puppets. You think that's big enough for Ruff's body?
Yeah.
I like it.
Now, this is the pattern for the sweatshirt sheet that you're going to make. Glue that in, and then you're going to slide it into the elastic of the sleeve. Some gray felt for the inside of his mouth.
Is the inside of my mouth gray? Really? It's too dark in there.
The basis of his face. That's looking good.
Hey, that's starting to look like me.
Great.
Hey. Hey, got the glasses, too.
Looks awesome.
Don't forget about the eyebrows that hover above my head mysteriously. All right, Willie and Mike are heading out to the park. And look what I have waiting for them.
Look. All right. From the desk of Ruff from. You think it's so easy to be me, huh?
Just like me.
You lucky dogs test your balance systems, muscle vision, inner ear.
No!
Uh-oh. This is gonna be so hot.
That's right. I want proof that all the advice you gave me actually works.
Oh, snap.
I got my buddies that are gonna laugh at you when you wipe out.
Maybe so. How are we supposed to put a helmet on?
Yeah, I don't see how you put up with all this fur.
I want to see what happens when you mess up the information your brain gets from your balance system.
Oh,
it looks like Ruff set this up for us.
That's supposed to represent the fence that he climbed on. We're supposed to test a balance.
Let's try inner ear.
Ready, set, go. One.
Remember, when they stop moving, the fluid will still be spinning, so they won't be able to use their inner ears to help them balance. Oh, hey, run the straight line.
Did I make it? Let's try it again.
Yeah.
Bring around the Ruffman.
Set, go.
Whoa, Mike's on the pavement. Willie made it.
Come on, Mike.
Balance, sort of, a little bit, maybe. Wipe out.
What was it?
I think it was a tie.
Not so easy, is it?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our show.
Oh, he's really good at that.
And I hope you enjoy Ruffman. And what should we call the show? Ruffman's hospital visit?
Hospital experience?
Once upon a time, there was a cat who could dance on a fence with the greatest of ease.
Wait a minute, who cares about a cat?
Show us your jealous face.
Wait, remove jealous and just say watching. Casually observing.
As soon as he does his jealous face, the cat will disappear, right? Why don't you bark at him? What would Ruff do? Would Ruff bark? Would you bark?
Yeah, I don't really bark much anymore. I send angry letters.
I'm coming.
Ruff, what's the matter?
I broke my leg.
Man, is that Ruff Ruffman or Marge Simpson?
Hospital.
What? Hospital.
There's food.
Okay, carry on. Okay, that's a good ride.
That's gonna be wonderful, guys.
Rosario, I'm definitely recording my own voice.
Okay, what is this stuff?
I don't know.
Shaving cream! Oh, look, we have a stopwatch, foam shoes, and bandana.
I think we have to do it.
Vision and muscles are left.
Let's try muscles.
I can't believe we're going to have to walk across in foam shoes.
That's right. The foam shoes are going to mess up their muscle information.
Go. You can do it! Oh!
Oh, yeah, he's doing well. He's almost made it. Maybe it is easier for these guys.
You're right!
Oh, he's covered in it!
Oh,
I'm trying not to laugh because that's kind of mean. Okay, see, that's what I needed at the base of my fence. A nice cushion and some shaving cream.
It's my turn!
Okay, yeah.
Uh-oh. Okay.
Let's see how Willie does.
Go. That's 45 over here.
Nicely done, Willie!
Now it's time for a visual.
Let's see how well these kids can balance when they can't see. Oh! Oh, hey, that's not fair! I should be covered in this stuff. Now, if they're blindfolded now, it's a lot harder.
Uh-oh.
You're taking away the vision.
You can do this.
I shouldn't be rooting for a wipeout. I really shouldn't, but this is just too tempting. And M-Dog made it across. Nice job, Mike.
Nice. Woo. All right. So, it isn't easy being you, Ruff.
But it was an awesome challenge.
See you back at the garage.
It's Studio G, Ruff. I mean, Mike. Wow, is that what I look like from the back? Oh, I need to diet. It's time for the show.
So, we're just getting ready?
Everybody's prop set.
Yep.
Group hug, everybody.
Yes. Break a leg. No, wait, don't. Good luck.
It's a grand moment.
Hey, I'm Bernie the Pig, and I want to welcome you to Ruff Ruffman's Hospital Experience. Once upon a time, there was a cat who could dance like nobody's business.
The cat can dance okay. Yeah.
And you know who was jealously watching this cat dance? Ruff Ruffman.
Our hero.
Well, I bet I could do that. All right, boys, let me hear. Fetch.
Go, Ruff.
But then, Ruff Ruffman got a little off balance.
No.
And he started. He started to fall.
Oh, dear.
In slow motion. We need help.
Hello, Ruff. What's the matter?
I think I broke my left leg.
Well, I'm going to take you to the hospital and we'll make it all better.
What? The hospital?
There's food.
Then maybe I should go.
I would probably go if I knew there was food involved.
Ruff Ruffman could not resist food, and so Maria the nurse carried him to the hospital.
Howdy, Ruff. I work in the hospital. It's really not that bad.
Just a little bit of gauze, not too much at all, just a little tiny bit. And there you go.
So, what happened? How does he feel?
Everybody say fetch!
Well, he's up and dancing!
We found Ruffman!
Yeah! And he lived happily ever after!
Healed up just like that? Oh, that's not so bad. I can handle that. Get in there and bandage me up real quick. Get a sandwich.
You guys did a wonderful job.
Y'all did too.
Oh, thank you, Bernie.
And all puppets aside, you were great puppeteers.
See you back at the garage, Ruff.
See you back at the garage, Ruff.
What am I, the only Ruff that can get it straight? All right, people, it's time to bring Mike and Willie back in.
Nice to see you both.
Ruffmans. Okay, they gave life and personality to Sox, Bridget and Rosario.
Hey guys. Oh my gosh. Hey. Look at you guys.
That is the coolest puppet of me ever. Nice work, guys. And just because I have a cone on my head doesn't mean I can't give out some points.
Yeah.
All right, Mike, Willie, for spinning and wobbling your way to greater balanced knowledge, 40 points.
Yeah.
For fulfilling your lifelong dreams of being autologists for the day, 20 points.
Yeah.
And for looking good.
I look rough. I look like you.
And reenacting my less than proudest day, 20 points.
All right.
For a total of 80 points.
Nice, you guys.
All right, Rosario, Bridget, you've definitely eased my fears about hospitals.
What? Am I going to get a cast?
It's not that bad.
Out of 20 points, a solid 15. And for making some awesome puppets, including a pretty fab one of yours truly, 30 points. And for writing and performing an excellent puppet show, 40 points. For a total of 85 points. But is that all the points all these dogs can give?
No.
What time is it? A rare double bonus point giveaway. Bridget, for not just leaving me on the ground, but performing an impromptu puppet rough rescue mission instead. A bonus 5 points for you. And Mike, that dive into shaving cream may not have been pretty.
You're right.
But it made for good TV. 5 points to you. Which means, Bridget, with 90 points, you're today's daily winner. Now, Bridget, we have here two cones. Behind one is an amazing prize. And behind the other, the best I could get for 60 cents. Which is it going to be, cone A or cone B? The cone on my head does not count. Do not select that one.
B.
Bridget, you will find your prize in the mailbox.
Go, Bridget. Go, Bridget.
Until next time, gang, keep looking like me. I'm going to the hospital. Hey, great news, Blossom. I've just come back from the animal hospital, and it's only a sprain. So I don't need a cast. I just have to use crutches for 2 weeks and wear this new cone. I have to do some errands? Okay. Oh, tuna sandwiches are on the table? Well done, Blossom. Okay, this is a little difficult. Ooh, I've got an idea. No, that didn't work as well as I was hoping. Can someone get this cone off me, please? Anyone? Murray?
Whatever.
You have to check out my website at pbskidsgo.org. There's tons of great games and lots more. It's like diving into a big pool of turkey gravy. pbskidsgo.org. The Fetcher Spotlight's on. Nina. She's a terrific cook.
Corn. Too bad you can't eat it.
She's very sharp.
We're gonna steer with our feet, then we can break with our hands.
She's a talented makeup artist. Sometimes. And she's got an eye for fashion. Check out all of Nina's incredible challenges.
Don't let go.
Only on Veg with Ruff Ruffman.